In this video, we are going to show you how to construct a simple on-site biodegradable toilet waste biodigester. The simple on-site biodegradable biodigester toilet system in Ghana uses anaerobic technology whereby microorganisms break down biodegradable materials in an oxygen-free environment. These biodigesters that this channel consistently talks about are used as simple biodegradable means of disposing of human waste, which is also not the same ones that produce gas or biogas as an output. After site selection, preparation and marking, the next step is obvious, that is the digging. For this type of digesters, we prefer them in rectangular shape mainly because of the bedding materials that we were using when they became prominent. A rectangular shape digester and a shape pipe that is about 4 inches, 3 inches or even 2 inches PVC pipes are all good for the black water that comes out into the soco pit. Step 2. After site selection and preparation and marking, the next step is the digging of the ground for the installation. Digesters should ideally be sited at a well drain area. Make sure that when you are digging, you get the measurement right. You also need to take into consideration the slopes and gradient for the digester's black water or wastewater and its drainage into the soak hole pit. So from your site marking and digging, this shape or a diagram like this is what you are trying to achieve. That's a rectangular shape for the digester and then a circular shape for the soak hole pit. The key consideration in your digester size mainly depends on the number of users and type of property you intend to put the digester to use. The next step to follow is to lay the blocks. That's if you are using blocks for your work, or erect the prefabricated slabs. With the required depth and size achieved, the next step is the erection of the biodigester bed. Usually, there are two types of materials used for this. We have the normal block laying process or bricks. Now we have erected our slabs and fastened the loose ends together. This will be held and further strengthened with mortar at all the joints of the precast slabs. The next step is to prepare a soak hole pit and then the drain area. The soak hole pit is basically like a soak away, but obviously it has to be filled with stones for the easy penetration of the wastewater. So in preparation for the soak hole pit, you need to consider the users and probably the lifestyle of the people who are going to use the facility. But for a standard typical biodigester, a 3 feet circular or diameter soak hole pit should be okay. The key consideration here again is to ensure that it's deeper than the digester bed and has enough slope to let out the black water from the digester bed to insert a drain or leche pipe into the biodigester. The waste drain pipe, or better still, the leche pipe is a key differentiator when it comes to biodegradable waste biodigesters. Because you are looking to achieve a digestion through an anaerobic process, you want to have a way to filter water that comes regularly into the biodigester. This is where the leche pipe comes in. So we'll connect it into the soco pit to do just that. Do screeding inside the biodigester box with sloping leading to the leche pipe and also leading into the soak hole pit. With mortar mixed at the required ratio, you have to do screeding of the digester bed floor. In some cases, and depending on the soil, a concrete mixture could also be used. You can then go back and finish the soak hole pit while the screeding dries, awaiting the digester bed installation. Fill the soak hole pit with stones or rocks or broken blocks, depending on which one is available to you. This allows for easy penetration of the wastewater into the earth surface and allows for longer use. So we are going to fill the soak hole pit to the desired level, making sure that it goes above the leche pipe all the way to the top before using a black polythene bag to cover it. What this does is that if no concrete or pavement or tiling is done on the ground of the compound, rainwater will not render the soak hole pit ineffective. The next step is to fabricate and install the biodigester filter bed. To support the digester bed and its subsequent load, use bricks, blocks, or in our case, specially designed porous slabs for the bed support. Place them neatly along the edges of the biodigester from one end to the other. If it is a bigger digester bed, an extra blocks or stones can be used to ensure that there is enough weight to hold the bedding material. Ensure that there's spaces to allow for the wastewater or the black water to have an easy passage into the leche pipe through to the soak hole pit. The next thing to do is to place the pervious concrete or the porous slabs on these particular blocks or slabs. This is done mainly for the enhanced filtration of the wastewater. Now ensure that the slabs covers the complete digester bed from end to end, and then cover the bed with fiber net or mosquito netting. Make sure you tack it to the sides and then tack it from end to end as well. There must not be any space left around the digester bed. The next thing to do is to cover the net with your chosen or available biodegradable materials. We are going to use the beaten coconut husk, which has been treated into a fiber. So we call them coconut fiber. You ensure that the fiber covers all the surface of the digester bed and is spread all across the digester bed to receive the human waste. And finally, cover the biodigester with the top slab and then seal it. The digester covers can then be used to cover and seal the digester completely, making sure that it is sealed airtight. Use mortar to seal around the digester and design it to suit desired look and feel. We have other videos on the channel that shows how biodigesters work and how they are changing the human waste situation in our part of the world. Click on them and watch some of the videos that we have.